Hi guys, what's up? It's Anna and welcome to my world. Today I am back, of course, for another crystal video. This is one that I've been wanting to make for a while and I'm really excited to finally be able to sit down and make this one. So I'm hoping by doing this I can help out you guys who are maybe questioning on whether your crystal is a real natural crystal or if it's man-made, because I know there are some that are really confusing to know whether they are man-made or not, and I know people have a lot of questions. So I'm here to debunk that for you guys. So if you're interested in knowing the top man-made crystals that are not actually natural and a little bit about them, then make sure to subscribe to my channel before you leave and hit that bell notification so that you can be notified every time I upload a new video. And with that being said, let's go ahead and hop right on in. Okay guys, so in the crystal world, there are the natural crystals, there are crystals that are natural and man-altered, and there are just plain man-made crystals, which are glass. So I'm going to be breaking down a few of the most popular ones today so that you guys know and you don't get your hopes up thinking that you're getting a natural crystal. There could be some people out there that, you know, trick you and will put this is natural when it is not. And so I'm going to go ahead and tell you about that. So let's go ahead and start with the ones that are just completely and utterly man-made. So I don't own any of these in my personal collection because I'm not about the man-made crystals, but these are ones that are popular and that are still very, very prevalent in the crystal world. So I'm gonna go ahead and start with smelting quartz. This is my least favorite. All this is, you guys, is glass. And you can literally go to Dollar Tree and get like a smelting quartz paperweight for like a dollar. This is literally just glass, but people sell it in sphere forms and tower forms. They'll charge an arm and a leg and they'll make it seem like it's, you know, a really crazy cool natural crystal when in all reality it's not, and it's just glass. I will say, of course, and don't quote me on this, but this is what I have heard and read before, and of course my source may not be true, so like I said, don't take this at heart and do your own research, but I believe quartz is, or glass is, quartz in its most natural form, free of all impurities. So I mean, if that does anything for you and like deciding whether you want smelting quartz or not, but other than that, it truly is just glass. Please don't like get, you know, charged an arm and a leg for smelting quartz, because you can get it anywhere for cheap as dirt, basically. So that is the first one that I wanted to cover. Now number two, we're going to go to what is, in my opinion, from what I've seen, is the most popular man-made crystal out there, and it confuses a lot of people, and this is the main reason why I wanted to make this video. So now, this is a crystal that I have sold in my own shop before, but it's because this one is still one that is not, that you're not gonna like find in the store like smelting quartz. It is still extremely popular, and I hold more of like, it's not honor, but I appreciate it more than I do smelting quartz. Smelting quartz is just a big absolute like no for me, but this one is opalite. So a lot of people think opalite is opal. It's not. Opalite is not opal. It is not an opal. It is not worth what an opal is worth. It's just not. Opalite is man-made. Opalite is something that is a form of glass, and then it is used like with aura, or aura is used, or other different like chemical compounds from the earth are used to create aura that gives it that appearance. Yes, they kind of mimic some opals, but opalite itself is not an opal. It is just glass. Now, I do sell this one in my shop occasionally. I don't get it in personally unless it's just something like really cool and really cute. Like I had opalite ghosts and I had an opalite penguin. Those are super cute and they are still very popular in the crystal world. So since they are so like known, I feel like that makes them have a little bit more credit, and I don't mind it as much. But just don't, basically I'm making this to say, don't let someone fool you by like a shop description saying that that is opal. Opalite is in fact man-made. So that is the second one I wanted to cover, and is probably honestly the most popular one. So those are the two like fully man-made crystals. Now I want to go on to one that is mostly man-made, but it does have some properties of natural things in it, and that is sandstone. sandstone, yes, it does look really beautiful with the literal like bajillion sparkles that make it look like a night sky. You have blue sandstone, red sandstone, green sandstone. I get it, like the sparkles are really, really pretty. But that's another one of those is glass. But whenever they make it, they do use like different natural minerals that come together in a sciencey way. Sorry, I don't know how to explain it because I'm not a scientist or a chemist or whatever, but they do it with like natural minerals in order to make up the compounds of it to like have it sparkle and to be, you know, the way it is. So you do get mostly glass and then the natural compounds in it, but it's still, that one's in that borderline. So I feel like, you know, here is all glass. This is the middle, which would be like sandstone. And then I'll get to the last category after this one. But if that makes any kind of sense at all, and I did any kind of good and any kind of justice with explaining it, that's kind of what's up with sandstone. It's one that's very popular. I've seen it in like all the crystal shops I've been to. I've sold like maybe a piece here and there, because again, I feel comfortable sharing that one because at least it has some naturalness to it, even though it's very, very minimal. It's just popular, so I'm fine with it. But it's one of those that I don't go out of my way to get tons of still. But anyway, just know what you're getting. What you're getting is not something that just grew out of the ground. So that is sandstone, and that makes number three. So for number four, number four has some like subcategories to it. And now number four is my favorite of ones that are altered. And I actually have two pieces in my personal collection, and one that is one of my favorite crystals I own because it was one of the first ones I got when I got into crystals, and I didn't realize that it was partially like altered. But once again, this is okay because let me explain. Okay, aura quartz. Aura quartz is not grown in the ground as that rainbow aura appearance. Okay, so the reason why I love this one, I think it's okay, and I get it in my shop all the time, is because they use real crystals such as clear quartz or other like forms of quartz, and they just use like minerals and like extreme heat to put a coating over top that is the aura. So you're still getting that real crystal. You're just getting, they just put like a coat of like aura on top. And that's how I describe it when I sell them in my shop. I'll say, okay, this is the quartz cluster and it has aura coating on top, because that's just what it is. And the ones that I have, there are a different array of these auras. So you have like angel aura quartz, you have titanium aura, and those are the two I'm going to show you today. So one of them that I have that, like I said, is one of my favorite crystals is this beauty. So with this beauty, you get all of the natural like clear quartz with all the inclusions and the sparkle all on the bottom, right? It's in the cylinder kind of, you know, shape, which is super cool. And then it's just the top layer that has the aura coating. So as you can see, this is all real and natural crystals. It's just got the aura coating on top. And I am completely and utterly fine with that. I don't think anything's wrong with it because this is still natural. It just has that really cool coating on top. But basically, my warning with this is just to know that, if you don't already know, that the aura itself, it doesn't grow out of the ground like that. That part is heat treated and done in a lab, but you're still getting the real crystal. So that's the important part to me. And then the other one that is angel aura, this is all just about the type of aura. This is a real big, awesome, gorgeous piece of clear quartz. This is exactly how it grew out of the ground. All of this really, really pretty, like all of the different, like, what is the word? I guess I could say towers, but all the little like natural towers coming out. But if you can tell, it's really hard and it's not focusing, I know. But it has like the softest, lightest, opaly color to the rainbow. And that's why it's called angel aura. It's so hard to tell, I know. But that's just the type of aura it is. So if you see anything with aura, whether it be titanium aura or angel aura, just know you're getting a real cluster of crystals. Or maybe it is not even a cluster, maybe it is, you know, a polished one, but you're getting, or semi-polished, but you are getting the real crystal with an aura coating. Also, aura can be placed on basically any type of crystal, as I've seen aura howlite, etc., etc. It's just the coating they're putting on top. So I really hope that that cleared some things up for you guys. A lot of the things are hard for me to kind of explain for the sense that I'm not a scientist or a chemist, but I tried to explain the best I could. But I still hope it, you know, cleared the air for you guys. It helped you to know so that if you are wanting to buy these crystals, you don't get scammed or confused and that you know what you're having. So I really hope this helped. Let me know down below, did you know these were man-made or man-altered? Let me know down below what your thoughts are. Are you into that? Would you own one? Let me know what you're thinking down below. And other than that, please make sure to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel before you leave. You can do that by hitting my face right up there, and you can watch another video by clicking right over there. It would mean the world to me if you would do so. And I hope you guys have a great day or night or whenever you may be watching this, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.